minimum of the functional, this very kind of functional. In this lecture, we state the theorem on necessary and sufficient conditions for existence of minimum of the functional generated by the positive definite operators. Namely, Euler-Lagrange equation of the following functional f of u equals L u minus 2 f u in the domain of the operator L, f in the Hilbert space, capital H. The Euler-Lagrange equation for this functional is not only the necessary condition, but also sufficient condition for existence of the minimum of the very functional in the domain, in its domain capital DL, provided that L is a positive definite operator. We note, we remind that U is called regular solution of the abstract equation LU equals F if U, the solution of the equation, is in the domain of the operator. The following theorem on regular solutions holds. The theorem. Let L be a positive definite operator in the Hilbert space capital H. If U in the domain DL is the regular solution of the linear equation, abstract equation, LU equals F for a given function F in the Hilbert space, then the functional f of u attains its minimum at u, at the L, at the solution u in the domain. That is, the smallest value of the functional f over all possible values is f of u, is at the solution u. And if the functional attains its minimum at u, then u is the regular solution of the linear equation. So the Euler-Lagrange equation is the necessary and sufficient condition for existence unique solution, a regular solution of the abstract equation. Regular solution means solution in the domain of the operator. Now let us see the proof of this very interesting theorem. At first, we assume that U in the domain DL is the regular solution of the linear abstract equation LU equals F. Then the following identity holds, that for every function u in the domain of the operator, by the definition, the operator is the functional f is LVV minus 2FV. That is definition of the functional where L is a positive definite operator. This, evidently, F is the right-hand side, U is the solution. So we can put instead of F, this F, we can put LU, LU equals F. But other elements V are as it is. So, but this equality, we observe that it is product L of the difference U minus V minus U times v minus u under product minus luu. That is to check only, to open the brace, to because L is positive definite, that means linear operator. Then of course we observe that we have LVV, which is this term. Then we have minus LVU, LV this U, and LU this V. Because operator is symmetric, is positive definite, then we have two LUV, minus two LUV. And also we have L minus LU, U. Then it will be plus LUU. If we subtract LUU, we remain with this very term. I think it's clear. The identity holds for all V in the domain DL. Hence, minimum of this very functional is minimum of this expression. But minimum is taken over V. We can manipulate only with V. U is a fixed solution. So, if we observe, if operator is positive definite, then this value, the smallest s can be, is zero when v equals u. So when v equals u, the minimum of the operator is minus luu, where u is the solution of the abstract equation. So we have proved that if u is the regular solution in the domain DL, then at this very solution, the functional attains minimum, and its minimum is this value, this number. Okay, so this happens when v equals u. Okay, therefore, we can note that fact that minimum of the functional over all possible values is the value of the functional f, and it is minus luu. Good. Now, thus we conclude that if u is a solution of the linear equation, then the functional attains its minimum at that in DL at this u. Now, let us assume that the functional attains minimum at the certain elements u at the domain DL. That is, we assume that f of u is the minimum over all possible values of the operator f, of the functional capital F. Then, what it means? If it is the smallest value, then the smallest value is less or equal than any value. That a value which the argument is shifted by the elements t eta for the real variable t and for any eta in the domain with that domain. So the functional attains minimum at this function when t equals zero. By assumption, we now assume that u is the element at which functional is has a minimum, and we want to conclude that then that u is regular solution of the abstract equation, opposite when we have said above. Okay, because the quadratic function of the real variable t, this is quadratic function, is quadratic function indeed. By the definition, this operator at the argument u plus t eta is lu plus t eta in the brace times u plus t eta. If minus 2 f times again, here should be plus t eta. Okay. If we open that, then we shall have the coefficient at t square will be t here and here. So it will be L eta coefficient at t square is L eta eta. It is positive because operator is positive definite. Then the coefficient at t. Then will be Lu eta this and L t L eta this. So will be twice here. And this coefficient will be Lu eta. Again, operator L is symmetric. Then we can write that fact. And minus 2 F eta. That will be also this plus here. So we have here in the square brace the coefficient at t. And free term will remain only here. That means free term will be Lu u, because u is fixed, minus 2 fu, which is f of u. Okay, so this is a quadratic function. This quadratic function attains minimum when t equals 0, what we have assumed here. So if t equals 0, the function has a minimum because the function has branches, quadratic functions up. That means this coefficient is positive because operator L is positive definite. Okay, so this function attains minimum at t equals 0. Therefore, the derivative of this function, what is the derivative? Is equal 0. But what is the derivative at t equals 0? Derivative of t with respect to of this term is 2t, and the coefficient when t equals 0, it disappears, it vanishes. Here, derivative with respect to t will be 2 times this brace. Derivative of this is 0. So it means that 2 times this brace should be 0. That it means this square brace must be 0. This square brace must be 0. We have written here in the way that we took we wrote as an inner product. Okay, this is the brace. And at t equals 0. So we have this fact. The derivative is equal to 0. But this is equal to 0 for all eta. For all eta in dl c0 omega, which vanish at the boundary of omega c0. That means that Lu must be f, because it other words to say that the element Lu minus f is orthogonal to all elements eta in the domain. That will happen if that element is 0. That is great. That is end of the proof. Now, to illustrate the theorem, let us consider the example. The operator minus second derivative is positive definite in the Hilbert space L2, 0, a. We know it from the previous lectures that this very operator is positive in L2 space. With the domain, evidently, of functions twice continuously differentiable, which vanish at 0 on interval 0a, together with the first derivative. So, by the theorem, the boundary value problem, this problem with homogeneous boundary condition, when f is from L2, possesses the regular solution in the domain, and the functional, this very functional, in the case of the operator is this one, attains the minimum at the solution, at this very regular solution u. That is conclusion from the theorem. Now, the theorem concerns only regular solution of differential equations, but not weak solutions. If f is not regular, then regular solution may not exist. So the theorem will not be applicable in the case. So we shall consider existence and uniqueness of weak solutions of a linear equation in the next section. Thank you.